Whether you're using Figma for work or for personal projects, it's important to know how to export content. You can export content to share with collaborators, facilitate the developer handoff, save copies of your work outside of Figma, or for any other reason you can imagine. In this video, we'll walk through how to export content and go over ways to troubleshoot common export issues. Let's get started. You can export any layer type from Figma, like objects, groups, frames, and sections. To export a single object, select that object and use the export settings to apply an export configuration. I'm going to select the blue circle and click the plus in the export section to add a new export configuration. When I open the preview, you can see that only the blue circle will be included in the export. Click the export button to export your object. The location of the export section differs depending on your level of access to the file and the mode you're using. If you have edit access to a file and are in design mode, the export section is located at the bottom of the design tab in the right sidebar. If you have view access to a file and are in design mode, you'll find the export section on the export tab in the right sidebar. If you're using dev mode, the export section can be found on the inspect tab in the right sidebar, but only if you have an object selected. Why don't I see the export section? If you're not seeing the export section, the file owner has restricted viewers from being able to copy or export content. You'll need to contact the file owner for assistance. If you want to export multiple objects at the same time, simply select the objects by clicking and dragging your cursor over them, or by holding Shift and then clicking on each object. You can then use the export settings to add the same export configuration to each object simultaneously. When you export multiple objects like this, they will each be exported to their own file. If you'd rather export several objects to a single file, there are a few methods you can use. First up are groups and frames. We'll talk more about exporting frames in a bit. To group objects, select the objects and use the keyboard shortcut, or right-click on one of the selected objects and choose Group Selection. Now, you'll see that the objects will be exported as one single file in the preview. Like groups, frames also act as a container, allowing you to export all of the objects inside to a single file. To add objects to a frame, use the keyboard shortcut or right-click on a selected object and choose Frame Selection. When exporting a frame with a fill, you can exclude the frame's fill from the exported file. To do this, select a frame with an export configuration and then deselect the Show in Exports checkbox in the Fill section. See how the preview changes to a transparent background? Pretty neat. If you're an editor of the file, the export configurations you create will persist and are visible to others in the file. If you're a viewer, your export configurations are not visible to others and do not persist after the file has been refreshed. Why isn't all of the content in my frame included in the export? When exporting a frame, keep in mind that only objects inside the frame will be exported. If you're running into issues with objects being left out of an export, make sure that the layer is nested inside the frame in the Layers panel and not just visually on top of the frame on the canvas. Checking the export preview is also a great way to make sure everything is where it needs to be. You can also use sections or slices to export several objects to the same file in a way that won't impact your overall design. You can find both the section and the slice tools under the Region Tools dropdown in the toolbar. Sections are great for organizing objects on your canvas. With the section tool selected, click and drag over existing objects to add them to a section. If you take a look at the left sidebar, you'll see that the objects become nested within the section layer. Keep in mind that when you export a section, the export will include the section name and background fill. Slices are a bit different than sections. When you add a slice, you'll notice a new object with a dashed border is added to your canvas. You can move and resize the slice as needed, but only content inside the boundaries will be included in the export. Once you're done exporting, you can delete the slice layer. You can also export the entire canvas of the current page. To do this, deselect everything by clicking a blank spot on the canvas or by pressing Escape on your keyboard. Click the plus in the export section to add an export configuration. If you open the preview, you'll see that the entire canvas will be included in the exported file. Keep in mind that if your file has multiple pages, you'll need to select and export content on each page individually. If you no longer need an export configuration, simply click the minus next to it to remove it. What if I want to export my entire file? You can always save your file as a local copy. This downloads the file as a .fig file, which is Figma's proprietary file format that can only be imported back into Figma Design. Keep in mind that the file's version history and any comments will not be included in the downloaded file. Now that we've walked through selecting content, let's talk about how to customize your exports. Figma supports exporting content into PNG, JPEG, SVG, and PDF files. The format you choose will depend on your needs. If you want to learn more about what each file format is best used for, check out the Help Center article linked in the description. In addition to the file type, there are some other options in the export section. First, there is the scale option. This determines the size of your export. With the scale set to 1x, the pixel values of the export would be the same as the ones listed in the right sidebar. If I change the scale to 3x, those pixel values would triple. Keep in mind that if you're exporting content to a PDF or SVG, the scale can only be set to 1x. In addition to the default scale options in the dropdown, you can also manually enter a custom scale. To export at a custom multiplier, enter a number in the scale field. To export at a fixed width or height, enter a number followed by W or H, respectively. By default, content exported from Figma has a DPI, or dots per inch, of 72. An image's DPI increases as the scale increases. To calculate the DPI of an image exported at scale, multiply 72 by the chosen scale. For example, images exported at 2x have a DPI of 144. If you're exporting content for high-density screens, like Retina displays, it's good practice to export your designs at 2x your intended asset resolution. Next to the scale option is the suffix field. By default, exported files have the same name as the layer you're exporting. The export button gives you a preview of what the exported file name will be. You can use the suffix field to add labels to the end of the file name. This can help you organize your exports without having to change the layer names in the file. If I enter -active in the suffix field, the exported file will be named button-active.png. There are additional export settings available for each file type. For more information, check out the Help Center article linked in the description. When you're happy with your export configuration, click Export. The exported file will be sent to the download location set in your browser preferences. If you're using Figma on a Mac, and named your layers in Figma using a /separated naming convention, objects you export will be organized in nested folders that match your naming structure. For example, if you export an object named button/pill/active, it will be exported nested in folders called button and pill and will be named active. When I export a variant, why are the variant properties being used for the file name? To help you stay organized when exporting variants, the exported file name will use the variant properties and their values rather than the layer name. For example, if you export a variant with a type property of primary and a state property of default, your exported file will be named type equal primary, state equals default. To avoid this, consider exporting an instance of the variant instead. In some cases, you may want to export an object at multiple scales or different file formats. You can apply as many export configurations to an object as needed. To export this frame at both 1x and 2x scale, click the plus in the export section to add another export configuration. Notice that Figma automatically sets the new export configuration scale to 2x and adds at 2x to the suffix field, but you can modify that value to fit your needs. If you want to export multiple objects that already have export configurations set, consider using the bulk export list instead. To access the bulk export list, go to the main menu, File, and click Export, or use the keyboard shortcut. By default, the bulk export list shows the scale and file format of every export configuration set on your current page. To narrow down your options, select the objects you want to export before opening the bulk export list. Clicking on a configuration's thumbnail brings you directly to that object on the canvas. Deselect the box for any selections you don't want to export, and then click Export. And there you have it. With just a few clicks, your designs are ready to be shared. If we didn't cover your question in this video, check out our comprehensive Help Center articles linked in the description, or let us know in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date on all things Figma, and we'll see you in the next one.